find an unconscious patient who is not able to be ventilated appropriately, it may be from a foreign body airway obstruction. Two items in our toolbox that may help with this situation include the laryngoscope and the Magill forceps. The laryngoscope usually comes in two pieces, the handle and the blade, and there are generally two sizes of handles, one for the adult and one for the pediatric patient. The blades come in several sizes, either straight or curved. Both types of blades are used by advanced life support providers during intubation. However, at the BLS level, the curved blades are the ones that are to be used for foreign body removal. The Magill forceps comes in various sizes as well, larger for the adults and smaller for the pediatrics. Some important points to consider when using these tools include the use of proper body substance isolation, or BSI, using the skill on only unresponsive patients, and never use the laryngoscope as a lever or fulcrum against the teeth or mouth. Improper use of these tools can lead to significant injury and can damage the patient's airway structure. The steps for this skill include choosing the appropriate sized equipment based on the patient's size. Assemble the blade and the handle, ensure that the light is bright and tightly secured in the blade. Position the patient's head in the sniffing position and hold onto the laryngoscope in the left hand. Insert the blade into the right side of the mouth and displace the tongue to the left while visualizing the obstruction. Holding the Magill forceps in the right hand, remove the obstruction. Visualize the airway for any other obstructions before removing the laryngoscope blade. Finally, check for adequate air exchange and ventilate the patient as necessary. When using the laryngoscope and Magill forceps on pediatric or infant patients, use the same steps as an adult with some slight modifications. Hold the handle with the thumb, index, and middle fingers. On the infant, support the chin with the ring and little fingers of the left hand for leverage. From the cephalic position, insert the blade into the right side of your patient's mouth and displace the tongue to the left. Visualize the obstruction. Hold the Magill forceps in the right hand and remove the obstruction. Visualize the airway for any further obstructions before removing the laryngoscope blade. Finally, check for adequate air exchange and ventilate as necessary.